beginning at birth come. Honor thy father and thy mother, that thy days may be long upon the land which the Lord thy God giveth thee. Slaves, obey your earthly masters with respect and fear and sincerity of heart, just as you would obey Christ.
I was raised by my grandma in Coventry. She went blind when I was about 11. That's when I became a young carer. Funny thing about my grandma though, is even though she went blind, she could cook better than you, clean better than you, and she could walk faster than anybody who dared to accompany her to the shops. Now, my grandma was one of them blind people, so when they give you a blind stick, you're supposed to walk with it, tap, 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 you know, try and find your way. Not my grandma. She's waving it in the air like she's been leading a marching band. Now, my grandma was an old school Jamaican church lady, so my Sundays was ruled by a church, women in big hats, busting out in the spirit, he cock, you know them ones, yeah. And I was a good lad too, yeah? I was the top of Sunday school, I did my golden text, I did all my songs. Then I became a teenager. 8 Mile came out and we went mad. We battled at each other every break and every lunch. And if you lost that break, you better write something in third period. Because you're missing out on maths. And then suddenly, my brethren introduced me to Channel U, which is now called Channel AKA, yeah? And I was introduced to Wiley, Skepta, JME, and a whole roster of grind pioneers. And suddenly, all the way around the UK, there were men in school in gangs and that Bluetoothing each other instrumentals and showing each other bars and lyrics. When I got my first job, I invested most of that money into like recording equipment and stuff because I started getting known in my ends for making music and I wanted to do more. But at that time, my grandma started getting sicker and sicker to the point where she was bedbound. And suddenly she lost that independence that she was famous for. That independence he held on to so tight. And suddenly she was, you know, left dependent on my brother, my sister and I, and the district nurses, and I didn't mind. I love my grandma, but it could get annoying at times, especially when I was trying to record a tune. So I'm in my room, yeah? I've got my mixing desk, I've got my bars, I've got everything ready, I'm ready, yeah? New bars, mixed beat as well, yeah? Yo! Yo! Straight up and down, these heads in the beat, I spit shower like rain coming down, hydrating the drought, got fresh water taste in your mouth. I feel hungry in the face of the crowd, but no rest in peace, trying to chase me down, but it don't want to see. Made it out of the C-class, running to the C-class, bends too many much snakes in the grass, for a broken machine for us. Danny! Yes, Nan! What is it, man? You can't fix me, pick up for me? Man, I did that like 2 seconds ago. Like, I told you, I'm trying to work upstairs, isn't it? Like, you can't keep doing this, isn't it? Like, you know, in that span, we don't want to be a burden for nobody, you know? You can't fix this for me? So, I start fixing my grandma's pillow here, and it's like trying to get the right picture on an old TV, or trying to get like the right station on like an old FM radio. But I get it eventually, and I'm back upstairs, quick for us. I want to get it. I want to tune that. So, yeah. Yo. This is everything. Yeah, for the flutes instrumental. Yo. Militant like me, you could never be militant like tonight. You could never be militant like me. You could never be militant like tonight. Nah, I only need one mic. No hands straight to the point like Sprite. No more to war unless it's all for the motive seems right. But still, turn it off. Let me box my style in the head like 305. Even as I'm like calling it 305. I'm militantly and I'm on this diligently. And I will take the law into my own hands like a vigilante. If you ever hate a boy, go have sex with your auntie. I'm the hero, but I'm anti. Something like ridiculous spirit. Won't go for the normal way home. You'll be pranked out looking out home. Danny! have to like get her hands around the handles of the beaker, and you've got to like get her fingers ready because she wants to be independent. So you've got to, you know what I mean, put it for her. So she starts to sip it and too hot, man. So I put it on the side and I run back upstairs to go make a tune. But I know that like, eventually she interrupts me again. So I run back down there to give her the tea. Too cold, man! Okay, so I've got to go back in the kitchen to make her another cup of tea, yeah? But this time, because I don't want to get interrupted, I'll wait with the tea. Sit down and I'll wait with the tea. You know what I'm saying? So just when it's cool enough now, and I give it to her, just after she takes that first sip, yeah? What do you mean? Listen, all due respect, man, yeah? But we run around doing all of this for you, yeah? And do we get a thank you? No. But Jesus gets all the thank you, yeah? And as far as I'm concerned, you don't do nothing but hang up on the wall looking like Noel Edmonds. Done it again, yeah? I've tripped the Jesus wire in the house with my Instagram. I start getting cussed out about how nothing is possible without God and Jesus, and to be fair, I'm just raw not trying to hear it stuff. My grandma is a soldier, yeah? And she's been worshipping Jesus, doing that Jesus work since before I was born, since she was born. But since she's got like this, I'm not trying to hear it. And furthermore, I'm a grown rude boy now. You know, I smoke weed, I lick gal, and I carry a butterfly knife in the sock just in case Jesus don't save me in the rain or the house. Plus, I've been doing some research, yeah, and I found out, yeah, that religion has been a tool used against slaves back in the days, yeah, where they say, honor your earthly masters and all of these things, or fear the national guard, or fear hell, and all kind of thing like that. So I ain't even trying to hear none of that. Furthermore, I've been doing more research, and I've realized that black people didn't just turn up in the 1500s as slaves. We used to have empires and kingdoms and all this shit, and we weren't even like Christians or Muslims or none of that. And I try and explain that to my grandma, but, you know, it's interesting. Interesting thing, but she ain't really hearing it. Now, you got to understand, you know, I love my grandma, but I wish she believed in herself as much as she believed in Jesus. And these are my thoughts about that. Yo. All my life I've been angry. All my life I've been so confused. As a youth, I wonder what a child psychologist would call me if they had the knowledge of this. I went my whole life not acknowledging this. It's like, everything you believe in is bollocks and shit. Don't come around me talking about God and that shit. See, my grandma got sick to God and all that. But she keeps getting sicker, hobbling along and all that. All her joints getting sicker, hobbling along and all that. All her joints, sight gone and all that. Funny fingers, blind as she was in the heyday, she'd go out and do her thing and go shopping the same way. But nowadays, everything ain't the same, mate. But being that strong in the most bleakest of heart speaks volumes to me about how much she must have believed in herself. And that's why I just don't get it. I just don't see myself bleeding and sweating, crying, almost dying, working that hard just to give someone else the credit. Getting on my knees and begging the Lord, please, black man, don't take it. Believe in yourself and you set yourself free. Even Malcolm X said it. Don't ask for permission, make your own destiny. You see, I just don't get it. I just don't see myself bleeding and sweating, crying, almost dying, working that hard just to give someone else the credit. Getting on my knees and begging the Lord, please. Black man, don't play it. Believe in yourself and you'll set yourself free. Even Malcolm X said it. Don't ask for permission, make your own destiny. You did all the work. Start treating yourself better. You don't have to thank Jesus as well. Now she can't walk and her knees are all swollen. There's nurses, carers, more and more pills. She's telling me about the pain that she more and more feels. All these different complications the Lord will heal. You think for all these years she sat in the congregation, he'd hook her up to be a regular hospital patient, hoping and praying, watching and waiting. Lord, have mercy. She's telling me there's so much pain. Lord, please help me. I can't move. All time of the night she called, yeah, we came. Till now, even still, Jesus ain't passed through. Can't say that he came when we were in. Fam, she really can't move. And there's a lot of things that we really can't do. And there's a lot of time that we really can't lose. I swear that I'm gonna die. I'm hearing Jesus deliver me now. Do you know how depressing hearing Jesus deliver me sounds? Deliver you unto heaven or hell. And he's scooting around like an assassin doing his round. You pay your tithe enough, and what's he do for you now? I wasn't trying to be a bastard or play devil's advocate. But yo, still, yo, I just don't get it. I just don't see myself bleeding out, sweating, crying, almost dying, working that hard just to give someone else the credit, getting on my knees and begging the Lord, please, Batman, don't beg it, believe in yourself, and you set yourself free. Even Malcolm X said it, don't ask for permission, make your own destiny.
I'm not supporting a fraud, reporting.